سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم سليما كثيرا وبعد. إن شاء الله. Before we start, there is one question here. Is it true that a person will be considered a murderer or committing suicide Islamically if they have corona and they are not careful and mingle, then it's spread to other people? Yeah, if he deliberately doing that, because the Prophet ﷺ said, "Man qatala bil ayn ka man qatala bil sayf." So when somebody, he knows that he has this virus and he knows that he can harm people and so on, and he went and did it, yeah, the Prophet ﷺ, he said, "Whosoever kill people with the evil eye is like killing them with the sword." So we need to be careful, as I said. And the Prophet ﷺ said, "La darara wa la dirar." Do not harm yourself, do not harm others. And we need to be careful, because I don't know why people, they have to do that. And that is committing a sin in Islam. So, inshallah, as we've been talking, inshallah, about this gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we want to see the good side of this coronavirus. And this really, subhanAllah, is a rich experience, my brothers and sisters. I hope you see it this way. Shaitan, as I said, is your enemy. He will not let you benefit from this. He will not. He will make you focus on news, on depressing news, and this and that. And his goal is to steal your faith. Have you seen? I didn't do a study, but people are more scared, maybe the Muslims. Why? Because they are the only people that they have something that Shaitan will steal. Shaitan will not go to an atheist or whatever, because he doesn't have nothing to steal from him, but he wants to steal your faith. So pay attention. And as I mentioned, this is our golden days. They are passing by. Tonight is the beginning of the second day of Sha'ban. And who knows, maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is preparing us for Ramadan. Imagine we carry with us to Ramadan this, subhanallah, state of our heart when we are closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and this and that. How Ramadan is going to be, inshallah. Amazing. But still we are learning from this. But I want to say one thing that I want you to put it in front of you. That will help you. Because now people are waking up and they start addressing the real issues. And one of the real issues now that they are addressing is the psychological implication of this. People, as I said, they are suffering. People, they are hurting, and it will start appearing later on, because Shaitan, this is his target, his weapon is the fear and anxiety and so on. So I want you to pay attention to few words, as I said. And before I say that, let me establish one principle with you. The dangerous things that can happen to you when you follow the secular definition and explanation, that's very, very dangerous on you and your faith. I'm not talking about the scientific definition and explanation. Alhamdulillah, we listen to that and we take it. And I just answer the fatwa. The secular explanation, it means an explanation that removes the divine. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not in the picture. And I said in the lecture, just I finished with the sister, from day one, these two understanding or approach or system, they exist from day one. When Shaitan and Adam came down to this earth till the day of judgment, the system of Shaitan, the secular one, is the same, but different manifestations. And the religious approach of Adam, that's it. They will stay till the day of judgment. And sometimes people, they might mislead you, oh, you don't believe in science. Science is not secularism. No. Science is about facts. It has nothing to do with ideology. Secularism is an ideology. It removes the divine. So after this, listen to this, inshallah. Pay attention, please. How are you doing? I hope you are relaxed. Inshallah, everything is okay. You are in good hand. You are in the hand of Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. You are in the hand of the one who takes care of you in the womb of your mother, where you were nothing, you were weak, you can do anything. 9 months he took care of you. He will not take care of you now when he give you the brain and give you the body and this and that. You are in good hands. Just do your part. And the greatest part that you need to do is your heart. Trust him. And this is what I am doing. And that's my struggle. And this is my field that I will put all my effort in, inshallah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, listen to this verse and compare it to the secular approach. I want you to remember this. Part of the verse is not a verse, only part of the verse in Surah Al-Isra. Allah says about all this, what they call natural disasters. They are not natural disasters. Quran called them ayat, signs, verses. Allah says, وَمَا نُرْسِلُ بِالْآيَاتِ إِلَّا تَخْوِيفًا. Remember this, please memorize it. وَمَا نُرْسِلُ بِالْآيَاتِ إِلَّا تَخْوِيفًا is in Surah Al-Isra. Translation, and we send not the signs except as a warning. Let me say it again. And we send not the signs, coronavirus, earthquake, anything except as a warning. Remember this. If you understand it, wallah, it makes a huge difference in your life. What do you take from this verse? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not send these signs to kill people. I'm shaking your understanding. I know you are looking to me, Sheikh, what are you talking about? Didn't you hear that 8,000 people were killed by... Wallahi, they were not killed by that. It's the cause. But these people, God forbid, Allah already decided that they're going to die in this time. Don't equate the things together, because the verse said, إِلَّا تَخْوِيفًا. But these people, they die. If there is no coronavirus, they will die with something else because their time is over. I just received a YouTube from a doctor, a big doctor from, I think, Italy. He passed away today from coronavirus. Nobody can argue this doctor, he does what it takes to protect himself. Not like me or you, that sometimes we're not used to this. These people, they are trained to take precautions, and he died from it. It's not corona that killed him. That is the cause. We have to have a cause. Sometimes we have problem burying somebody a long time ago. Just the doctors, he didn't sign and say what is the cause of death. But the real cause, the time is over. مَنْ لَمْ يَمُتْ بِحَدِّ السَّيْفِ مَاتَ بِغَيْرِهِ تَعَدَّدَتِ الْأَسْبَابُ وَالْمَوْتُ وَاحِدُ. So when you understand this, and you know the goal, the objective, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving you the diagnosis. I'm sending these signs as a warning. So when the goal is achieved, that's it. Instead, you have to have some fear inside you. You have to. You remember the rule that we discussed? Nature does not accept vacuum. There is nothing, I don't fear anything. That's nonsense. But these verses are serving the purpose that you get rid of the fear of anything else and put the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because the fear of anything else or anybody, it will destroy you. The fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes you mashallah. Because the fear of Allah is not a negative fear. It's something else. So that is the goal. is to have the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you understand this, then Allah will give you the gift that you need in this time and every time. Without it, we're going to suffer. And please, because some of us may have this problem of fear and anxiety, do not share any news that you know and you send it. Maybe to you it didn't do anything, but somebody else. When people are talking now this and that, and I don't want to say it because I don't want to contribute in the same problem. So when you have this fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because you work on it now, I need to have it because you understand the verse where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sending this. What happened to you? Allah will give you the gift that you need now. What do you need? Not only in this time, in every time, is a sakina, the tranquility of the heart and the peace of the mind. That's what you need. Otherwise, people will suffer. Because subhanAllah, shaitan will come to you with that fear of what will happen to you. You know, today, if you go there, now you have to wait for these days before you are tested. And if you test positive, there is no bed in the hospital. And there is this, and there. And by the way, most of these things will not happen. And if I add fear, word fear itself, it stands for what? F-E-A-R. False evidence appearing right. Right there, you can use this one to help you. But Allah give you this sakina. Sakina. That look, subhanAllah, when the Prophet ﷺ and the companions and other prophets were in dangers, what they were given? Sakina. When the Prophet ﷺ and Abu Bakr, they were in the cave. And you know, the Quraysh came on the top of the cave. What do you need? Sakina. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He revealed His sakina. The people of the cave, you know, they run away from their families and people. And they are young people, 15 years, because Allah says, إِنَّهُمْ فِتْيَةٌ. Imagine going to the mountain where there is no light, there is no nothing, and entering a cave. What make the cave for them as palace? Is the sakina. Allah says this in the Quran, go to that. When Yunus was in the belly of the fish, in the arm of the ocean, what helps him? Sakina. Sakina is the tranquility of the heart. Has nothing to do with your body. Your body, you need to do what you need to do. Please, I hope by now we can differentiate between two. Asbab, do it, do it. But that sakina of the heart, that really defined out now. And as I said, maybe to sisters now, they are, most of the program now is to psychologists and psychiatrists. They are talking. Because people are suffering. I don't know what corona has to do with gun shop, there is no more guns. All of them are gone. Why? Because the fear, that anxiety. So when Allah gives you that sakina that He gave to the Prophet ﷺ in Al-Cave, and He gave the people of Al-Cave, and He gave Ibrahim when he was in the fire, and He gave the Muslims in many battles where they were scared. It's a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You can't buy it, you can't do it. You get it from what? From, as I said, you believe in Al-Qadr, you believe in Allah, and put the fear of Allah inside you. What is coronavirus? It's nothing. It's nothing. But when you have that fear, you don't see the other things. I just mentioned in the lecture that Allah gives you something stronger and stronger than coronavirus, which is your immune system. But you don't pay attention to that Because when the Sakinah is not there, you don't pay attention to anything. And you start harming yourself without knowing. And now they find out the number one killer of the immune system is stress and fear and anxiety. I'm not saying that I have it, but I'm sharing with you. That's why these things, as I mentioned yesterday, الَّذِي يُوَسْوِسُ فِي صُدُورِ النَّاسِ not فِي عُقُولِ النَّاسِ, the one who whisper in the breast of the human being, not in their mind, because Shaitan can't do anything here, because here is facts. But it's here. Emotions are here, fear, love, all these things are here. You waswas and magnify things and so on for you. So you need to make those dua as much as you can. Hasbunallah wa ni'mal wakeel. This is something that you need to do, and there is something that you should not do, which is don't listen to the news. Until you become strong, at least. When you become strong, this news will not affect you. But now it will affect you. It affects me. I don't listen to it. Except what I need to know. Because even for the media, they are not neutral. I'm not saying conspiracy. No, they are non-neutral. Why? Because if they are neutral and talking about facts and so, nobody will listen to them. There is a statement in the media world that says, when it bleed, it lead. Yeah, people, they want to know, wow, this one killing here, this and that. People watch that. So don't watch that. It's not enough to make the dua unless you remove this. And don't talk to negative people and people who are... No, don't do that. Even though my talk was about something else. Is how we can benefit. Every day, every time for the last 4 years, we were in the defense. Alhamdulillah, coronavirus is not by Muslims. Alhamdulillah. But every time we are cornered, we are in the defense. No, we should be in the offense. What does it mean, the offense? Talk about Islam, talk about God. That was my talk. But because I talk every day with people and so on, and I can feel and I see it. As I mentioned to the sisters, you know, in these days, the whole family is at home. And please, this is an advice, because maybe some of you, you didn't hear it, that when your kids, your children are acting out bad and so on, don't punish them. Please don't punish them. Because maybe they are doing that out of fear. Because life is changing for them. Why we are at home? Why we are not going to school? Why my father is at home? Why my parents are scared? And they don't know how to explain that and talk about it because they are young. So they are acting in this way. So talk to them and say, are you scared from something and this? And the greatest favor you can do to them, don't watch too much TV and news. And have a routine, have a routine. Don't change your lifestyle because of coronavirus and you are not going out. No, don't. So in the morning, if you are a person that go to work at 7, wake up the same time. And the first thing you need to do, remove your pajama. Don't stay at home with pajama. Because, subhanAllah, there is psychological connection with your heart and mind and what's going on. Because when you are dressed and you work and do things and have that routine and do some exercise even inside the house, what does it mean? The signal that they are sent to your heart, everything is okay. But when you change your heart, say, what's going on? There is something here not normal. But especially with your children, because they are scared. But we need that sakina and the peace of mind. The sakina is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَتَطْمَئِنُّ قُلُوبُهُمْ بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبُ. Those that their heart rests by the remembrance of Allah, indeed, by the remembrance of Allah, the heart find rest. Many people are suffering, as I said. And here it takes us to the main point, that we need to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for iman, for faith. That's why the secular people and atheists, they are making fun of you and me. Look, these people, they are asking heaven for solution while the problem is on the earth. You see? Even that, they want to take it from us. But some Muslims, by their action, like the question that they have, might confirm that. Ahna, we are not against science. We are against secularism. We are against it. And I will tell you, even though I was thinking to talk about this on Friday, inshallah, but let me say it tonight, because who knows? There is nothing called tomorrow, just moment, inshallah. How we solve our problem as believers? And I spoke about this concept. I want you to master it. Please do me this favor. If you want to forget everything I said tonight, you can. But remember this. Remember the concept of V, letter V. V upside down. Many people, they use the concept of triangle. I don't. Because it's missing one thing. Upside down V, it doesn't have a base. So follow with me. On the top, there is Allah. On one side here, the bottom, me. The other, what I need, what I want. So what does it mean? You cannot get what you want directly, because there is no base. You can't. You have to go. Me going to Allah, He will get me what I want. So when we are supplicating to Allah, when we are repenting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what are we doing? To this atheist, we are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have mercy on us and to forgive us. So when He has mercy on us, what He will do? He's not going to send a miracle. But what He will do? And listen to this. It will inspire somebody to find the solution. It's very simple. Very simple. He will inspire somebody. And I'm 100% sure, that's my opinion, that the medicine or the vaccination already exists. It's there. The one who created Corona, He created the medicine for it. It's already there. But He's waiting for people to repent, to have that mercy. To buy that mercy, our good deeds, our repentance buy us the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is merciful, He will inspire somebody to find the medicine. You will see. Remember what I'm telling you. And the proof is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what he said. None of you will enter Jannah by his good deeds. Most of us, we know this hadith. Then the Sahaba, the companion, think, maybe we don't do much. Let's ask him, what about you? He said, even me. Look, the Prophet ﷺ, who does good deeds more than anybody else. He said, even me, I will not enter Jannah by my good deeds. Except if Allah has mercy on me. So if that is the case, why we need to have good deeds? Good deeds buy us the mercy of Allah. Buy us the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when He is pleased, when He is merciful, then He gives you what you want. The secular approach doesn't say that. And they are making fun of them. I hope you understand this. That's why when they're going to find this, inshallah soon, they're going to call it discovery. That's what they say, the iktishaf. Because it's there. Because Allah, He knows us that we are weak. We can't without His help. إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدْ إِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. SubhanAllah, now every Muslim is talking about this. Let me add also my two cents to it. That SubhanAllah, the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imagine when these super countries and superpower, they want to show their power. What do? A parade. and they bring their new weapons and this. You see it here in America and Russia. You see, subhanAllah, you get scared. Look what's happening. When Allah wants to show His power, He shows it with something you cannot even see. People, they have to show their power, their muscles. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent something that even you cannot see. He said, "Where? Here is the real power." You can't. I was reading an article from somebody, really, mashallah, he made it. He said, "We used to be deceived. We were living in illusion that there is superpower and there is a big country, small country, this." He said, "Well, coronavirus really did us favor that there is, we are equal, all of us. Superpower, they can do anything. Some small power, they did something." So this religious approach is vital. So otherwise, the Prophet ﷺ, he did everything what it takes in Badr, and he made the best structure for the battle and so on, and he went and started crying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because he knows the upside down V, and this applies in our life. You cannot get what you want directly. Go through. I don't know if I'm qualified to give this example, and my two brothers are in front of me. May Allah reward them for this and what they are doing. May Allah protect them and their family and everybody who contribute to this that we are doing, me and Sheikh Taha and so on. I know we are in front and we take the credit, but really the credit should go first to Allah and to these people behind, that you don't see them, but Allah sees them. You know, when you send an email or you do a phone call, it doesn't go directly to the recipient. It goes through a server. I hope I'm correct. It doesn't go straight. وَلِلَّهِ الْمَثَلِ الْأَعْلَى. Allah has the best example. When you know that, you understand what does mean, the power of dua, the power of repentance, the power. The medicine is there. Don't think it's not there. It's there. And I follow this in my life a lot, about these people that they find out, like penicillin and this. These people, they were just sometimes sitting after thinking and they find it. Oh, I found it. So it's there. It's there. But before Allah inspires somebody, the goal must be achieved. And what is the goal? وَمَا نُرْسِلُ بِالْآيَاتِ إِلَّا تَخْوِيفًا. The warning has to take its place in the hearts and the mind of the people, and especially the believers. Especially the believers. When that is there, Allah will have mercy on us, inshallah. And I have no doubt, He will. And as I told you, don't equate coronavirus. This is a form of shirk, coronavirus, with I'm going to die or this. No. Alhamdulillah, these are ABCs. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the first thing He created is the pen. And He ordered the pen to write everything that is going to happen 50,000 years before the creation of heavens and earth. It's there. When you're going to die and how? It's done deal. That's why coronavirus, what will do to us after, inshallah, it's over, it's going to expose us, our reality, to do a checkup. It's going to get the best out of us or the worst out of us. And inshallah, we will cover this next time. So I hope this, inshallah, this word finds word to your heart. And be careful, as I said, people can manipulate you between science and secularism. Science is part of Islam, alhamdulillah. I don't have even to talk about that, but not secularism. Secularism means a definition, an explanation of the universe and what's going on without the divine. And now we have the same explanation, but we involve the divine. That's the only difference. So when you understand this, now we understand what does it mean, hasbunallah wa ni'mal wakeel, this and that and that. Because that is the price you pay to buy that tranquility of the heart and the peace of the mind. Tranquility of the heart, he is not scared. tranquility of the mind, he doesn't think. All of us, we've been there. When subhanAllah, you cannot stop thinking. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ وَآمَنُوا بِمَا نُزِّلَ عَلَى مُحَمَّدٍ وَهُوَ الْحَقُّ مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ كَفَّرَ عَنْهُمْ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ وَأَصْلَحَ بَالَهُمْ. إِذَا صَلَحَ الْبَالِ إِنْ صَلَحَ الْحَالِ. And subhanAllah, there is a correlation between your mind and your heart. They work together. And who suffers? Your body. In this pain in your stomach, in this and that. I'm not saying that I have what I'm telling you. But inshallah, Allah will give it to us as a gift from Him. We just do our best. So your job, as I said, achieve the goal. Remember the warning and make those du'as. That's why, subhanAllah, I think we have 2 minutes or three and we're going to stop. This qula, the two quls that I mentioned, and two quls according to the subcontinent, the three quls, the two quls, قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ. They are amazing. Especially when you understand them. And you cannot understand them fully unless you understand the other qul that comes before them. That's why they go three together in the sunnah. Because you are asking, قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ, I seek refuge from the Lord who make falak divide, مِنْ شَرِّ مَا خَلَقْ, from the evil of everything that he created. And قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ, you are asking a refuge with Allah from something. قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ, define who's Allah for you. Who's Allah that you, if you don't know the one that you are seeking refuge with, from, you might get the benefit, but not the full benefit. The full benefit, you get it when you understand قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ. That's why the sequence is like this. قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ, Allah is one. So he has no partner. Nobody can, Allah want to do something and somebody said, no, you cannot do that. Nobody can appeal. Nobody can tell him no. Nobody can override his decision. قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ, اللَّهُ الصَّمَدْ. Samad is the one that everybody goes to for their needs. تَصْمُدُ إِلَيْهِ الْخَلَائِقِ, لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ وَلَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُ. When you understand this, this surah, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ, which is surah al-ikhlas, you will benefit from قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ. That there is no real power in this world except one, Allah. And here is the proof. Wallah, I was coming to the masjid. I see, wow, everything is empty. Where are people? Where are they? Where is I, we, where is it? Where is it? And subhanAllah, this is an idea about the Day of Judgment. Because many people said, well, I don't know. Here is now. You can see a sample of the Day of Judgment. لِمَنِ الْمُلْكُ الْيَوْمِ, to whom belong the dominion today. You can see. And now we don't need this to believe in the other one, but really it increases your iman. لِمَنِ الْمُلْكُ الْيَوْمِ, لِلَّهِ الْوَاحِدِ الْقَهَّارِ, only to Allah. So trust him, inshallah. And just keep doing it. Shaitan is going to take you away from this adhkar. This is what you need to do. Once you have that sakina, wallahi, coronavirus or anything doesn't bother you anymore. It will not. So the adhkar, hasbunallah wa ni'mal wakil. The three calls. The dua of Yunus, La ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu min zalim. My brothers and sisters, if this thing doesn't work, why Allah said it in the Quran? So mean the whole Quran, and if this thing is nonsense, it works. Because Allah guaranteed the result. When Allah spoke about Yunus, فَنَادَ فِي الظُّلُمَاتِ أَلَّا إِلَٰهَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ سُبْحَانَكَ إِنِّي كُنْتُ مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ. Look, subhanAllah, when he said this dua, Allah said immediately, we respond to him. And we saved him. Then Allah said, this is not only for Yunus. وَكَذَلِكَ نُنْجِي الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. That's your dua. And the Prophet, he urged us to do this dua. At least this, if you don't memorize others, just this one. And one of the best ones that you will be surprised. What this has to do with this is Salatu ala al-Nabi. Salatu ala al-Nabi is miracle. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the tranquility of the heart and the peace of the mind. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to take away this bala and this disease away from us, inshallah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have mercy on us. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have mercy on us. Allahumma inna nas'aluka al-afiyah fi dunya wal-akhirah. Allahumma inna nas'aluka al-afwa wal-afiyah fi dinina wa dunyana wa ahlina wa malina. Allahumma astur awratina wa amin rawatina. اللهم احفظنا من بين أيدينا ومن خلفنا وعن أيماننا وعن شمائلنا ومن فوقنا ونعوذ بعظمتك أن نغتال من تحتنا. يا حي يا قيوم يا حي يا قيوم برحمتك نستغيث. أصلح لنا شأننا كله ولا تكلنا إلى أنفسنا طرفة عين. اللهم لا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك فينا ولا يرحمنا. اللهم ارفع مقتك وغضبك عنا. اللهم ارفع مقتك وغضبك عنا ولا تهلكنا بما فعل السفهاء منا. اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا. اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا. Oh Allah, protect us and protect our family, our deen and our wealth and our masajid. Oh Allah, protect our brothers and sisters who are in the front line working in the medical field. Oh Allah, protect them, ya Allah. Oh Allah, give them peace of mind and give them the tranquility of the heart, ya Allah. Oh Allah, save them and save anyone that is working in that field. Ya Allah, they are in the front line. Ya Allah, they are putting their life in danger. But you are the most merciful. You never let down anybody that does something for you. Ya Allah, protect them and protect us and speed up the solution. Ya Allah, we cannot. We are so weak, ya Allah. We are so weak, ya Allah. Take this punishment away from us, ya Allah. We are used to your mercy, ya Allah. Treat us with your mercy and do not treat us with your justice. Rabbana atina fi dunya hasanatan wa fil akhirati hasanatan wa qina adhab an-nar. Wa salli Allahumma wa sallim wa barik ala Sayyidina Muhammad.